Okay, so that's research, analysis, and writing. Building on the importance of good communication, we now turn to flowchart diagramming. Now, if I just told you that without showing you all these diagrams, diagramming may have seemed like an odd skill to feature here. But as someone who came to tokenomics through a prior career as a financial analyst, I was really struck by the prevalence and importance that these visualizations bring to tokenomic analysis and communication. Financial analysts just don't make use of them to the same degree at all. That said, if you come from a systems engineering, coding, or computer science background, I'm sure you're much more familiar with these methods and have been using them for a while to do important and non-trivial work. Anyway, these charts are really helpful and important. I have even been approached specifically to design them for project white papers and pitch decks, and I see why. Consider that the way we get understanding from language is akin to a procedural process that we have to go through step by step. We read information, hold ideas in memory, and arguably, when we get to the last sentence, we can get a complete picture of what's going on, possibly with some extra thinking through. This kind of thinking style is really new in our evolutionary history. Our visual thinking, on the other hand, has had millions of years of training put behind it. When something's presented to us visually, we can be much quicker at picking up relationships and interactions within a complex system and take an integrated view of it as a whole. As this picture shows, Rube Goldberg popularized an entire gag genre based off this ability. But even though we're strong visual thinkers, ironically, a lot of people find these diagrams very hard to put together. That's because they require a solid conceptual clarity of understanding about how the economy is organized. And then yes, there's also that horrible fiddling bit where you try and find a way to arrange all these parts in the most elegant and clear manner possible. It also does take a little practice and judgment to decide what the relevant level of detail is. It won't always be helpful to illustrate every single item in the same chart. You may be able to group some of the smallest items into larger subprocesses and create a more understandable high-level overview that's based on these larger subprocesses. Anyway, you should be able to tell by now that these flowcharts aren't just useful for communicating with others. A good diagram will also serve you as a thinking tool to help you sustain your analytical clarity and incrementally develop your economic designs. This is so powerful, in fact, that an entire modeling tool, Machinations, has been built around this premise, with the aim of maximizing the leverage that we can get from this style of cognitive processing. We'll be giving Machinations a look a little bit later on. But back to the diagrams themselves. There's much more that could be said about how to design them properly, but for now I'll just highlight one detail that I think it's worth stressing. I think it's always worth paying close attention to the outermost boundary of your economy. That's the boundary that contains all the types of agents and processes that are exchanging digital assets that have been purposefully designed for it. Any processes exchanging at that boundary represent value flows going in and out of that whole economy. These are very important to understand to be able to evaluate the long-term sustainability of this economy. You can see these economic actions being highlighted in this linearized chart of the Star Atlas economy. And you can also see me making use of it in the highly simplified depiction that I use to explain the failings of the Axie Infinity economy. So what software options do we use to create these charts? Well, there are lots of options out there, but I'm not going to lie, as a finance guy, I'm such a Microsoft Office homebody that I frequently make mine in PowerPoint and haven't yet begun to experiment much with these other options. But if engineers make use of alternative packages, there are bound to be very good reasons for that. The token engineering community is a really great resource for knowledge and tools that are shared openly by enthusiasts and professionals who are bringing those engineering-based tools and approaches to tokenomics. And they recommend the following options. I share source links to these and more in the areas below this video for your convenience.